Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can connect specific Lambda versions and Lambda aliases to your API gateway. So this video is going to assume you already have an API, and if you don't, there's a video that I created that explains how to do that. It'll be linked in the video description. And this video also assumes you already have a Lambda function, which I can cover in a different video that'll be linked in the video description as well. In this video, I have a very basic Lambda function that returns a random number between two variables that are passed in through URL parameters. So over here in API Gateway, we're simply calling the actual function itself, which is going to default to the latest version. If we go to our Lambda functions and we go to qualifiers, we see both aliases and version have this latest thing right here. And so this is going to basically be whatever you upload to your Lambda function, and that's what you're going to get. However, this has problems where if you have a production API, and you want to upload something, you want to make sure that it's not going to production immediately, so you have time to test that. And so we can use versions and aliases to help solve this problem. So we're actually going to go ahead and create a new version. So clicking on actions, we can click on publish new version. We can add a description. However, I'm just going to leave that blank and click on publish. And we now have version 1. Now to show you how to call this specifically, it's actually fairly simple. However, I don't suggest you only do this. But if you go into Lambda functions right here, under the integration request part, we can then add a colon 1, so it matches this right here. If we notice, there's no triggers here. However, if we go back to our actual random number, we see that there's API gateway right here. And so with that said, if we go back and we click on the check mark here, we have to add the permission. We can click OK. And going back to Lambda on version 1, if we refresh, we then see API gateway is now calling version 1. However, this doesn't make too much sense because now it's never going to call the development version, but this is how you would specify a version. So we can go a step further. Under actions, we can create a new alias. We can call this dev, and the version will be latest. So whenever we're calling the dev alias on this Lambda function, we're going to always use the latest version, and so that's more useful for development. We can click on save, and then I'm going to create another alias and call this prod. Now the version can be version 1. So now with that said, we can click on save. And so now we got these two aliases, dev pointing to latest and prod pointing to version 1. So now we can go to API gateway. We want to edit the Lambda function. And this might seem complicated, but I'll explain it. We want to remove the 1 and add a dollar sign and two curly braces. Inside we need stage variables dot Lambda alias. We can then click on the check mark here and we get this message right here. So we need to open up our console. And I'm going to copy this entire code right here and paste it into the console. However, we need to edit something. So if we go to the very top line, we see in bold right here, random number and this stage variable, Lambda alias that we typed in, we need to actually edit that. So if we go to the end of that in our console, we can delete everything aside from the colon right there, and we can say dev. Dev is important because that has to match the exact alias you created previously. We created a dev and a prod alias. So I'm going to run this and we should get this statement right here, which means everything worked. And then I'm going to press up in my console to go to my previous command. And I'm going to go back to the dev part and I'm going to use prod. Okay, so we get another statement. And so that should work. And then we can close this. We can click on okay. Now we have to go back into our stages and go to our dev stage. We can go to stage variables. Here we can add a stage variable. And because we used Lambda alias before, we have to do this here. So Lambda alias has to be typed exactly the same way as you just typed it previously. The value for this one, because we're in the dev stage, will be dev. I can then click on that. Now we have to actually create a new stage. So I can go to resources and I'm going to deploy the API to a new stage. I'll call this one prod. We can click on deploy. Now under prod right here, I can go to stage variables. I'm going to add a new one. This will be called Lambda alias and the value will be prod. Click on the check mark here. So now what I want to do is if we go to our latest version of our Lambda function, I actually want to change this and let's say that this is going to be a bug. This typically returns a random number between two points, but let's say that just always returns 10 now, which was not what we want. I can then click on save. And this is automatically going to be pushed to the latest version right here. And so the alias of dev is going to have this code. So going back to API Gateway, if I go to the production endpoint and I click on my random number, I can then open this in a new tab. We see we need the minimum and maximum arguments. So So min equals 10 and max equals 20. We then get 15, 17, 12, etc. And this is using the prod stage right here, as we can see. However, if I change this to the dev, we get 10. If I refresh, we get 10. And so this is now calling the different function, which is the latest version of it. And so this is where the bug comes in under the dev situation. And now we can see this, and we can make sure that this is not a similar case when it comes to prod, because we want the production to always be the working code, and development might have bugs because obviously you're still developing things. And so this is how you're going to create different aliases for your Lambda function and attach those to API Gateway between two different stages within one API. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.